Henry, it's fantastic to have you here with us at Collector Mania. Have you been enjoying yourself so far?
So far, so good. I've never done one of these before. So, yeah, everyone's been very sweet. And, yeah, it's been kind of fun.
When fans have been meeting you this morning, what are the most common questions you've been getting from them?
Not so many questions, just people asking, people saying how much they missed Lost and how much they enjoyed it. And what else? They've been asking if I've got any further projects coming up. Yeah.
So, I mean, talking about Lost, obviously, it was a huge global phenomenon. What do you think it was about that series that captured people's imaginations so much?
Well, I haven't been asked that question for such a long time. But I think what happened, it was from all over the world. And it was just a fantastical show. And had a lot of mythology and a lot of big questions, and it was just very, very good television, I think. What I really enjoyed about it was that it dared to ask big questions, which I think a lot of television doesn't do. Whether people got them or not, it was up to them, and the idea of people saying that they didn't understand it, you know, just watch it again, you know, and you'll get something else out of it. So it was never very difficult to follow, I didn't think. You just had to follow it.
Back to your own experiences on set, are there any particular fond memories you have that always make you smile?
I miss Lost a lot. It was a very fun time. I maybe took it for granted a bit too much, but it was a really happy time in my life. And the overwhelming thing is that I got to live in Hawaii, and I still live in Hawaii, so that was pretty cool.
When fans meet you, are there any other shows or characters that they particularly express their affection for?
Strangely enough, The Mentalist. People have been coming up and talking about that, but it was a very brief thing compared to Lost. Lost was, for me, a major character and a major part of my life. Yeah.
You mentioned earlier on fans want to know what you've got coming up next. Do you have any specific projects you're working on at the moment?
I'm doing a TV show called The 100. And we start shooting that in Vancouver in July. End of July, August. And a few movies coming out. Not Another Happy Ending. That's a film I shot up in Scotland. Frank vs. God is something I shot in America. And... and then I've just directed my first short film called Dress, which is coming out soon.
The new TV show, 100, can you tell us anything more about that, what it's generally about or what your character is?
It's a sci-fi. It's for the CW, and it's about, set in the future, the world's had this awful nuclear accident, and we're in a spaceship that's dying, and there's about 4,000 people left in the world. And some of the younger people on the ship come back to the Earth, and it's it's a bit Lost-like, but it's a bit a lot of sci-fi. It's should be fun.
Here's the best place to ask this question. Sci-fi, of course, you know, a fantastic genre that everyone loves all around the world. What do you think people get from that genre that they don't perhaps from other forms of more sort of contemporary drama and real-world stories?
I think for me, anyway, it's the fantastical. And again, it's sci-fi is the only genre, I think, that you can ask really big questions. And you can take it any way you want. You know, it's boundless, you know.
Thank you for answering our questions. My final one, do you have a message to fans, I guess specifically Lost fans, watching this all around the world? Anything you'd like to say to all those people who love the show and miss it very much?
I just want to say thank you for being such great fans. I think the Lost fans have probably been some of the most supportive, ardent fans in the world. And one of the things I love about Lost fans is that they got together and created friendships, clubs, all because of the show, all because of the love of a show, and I think it's pretty cool.